on the issue of Canada's housing market, you said that you were wrong to predict housing prices would drop between 8 and 16%. I'm not sure you were wrong. I think you might have been early. I think there is another chapter to unfold in this story. As your data has shown, for a house to be affordable, it shouldn't, the monthly payments on it should not consume more than 30% of pre-tax income. Right now, the average house costs the average family 50% of pre-tax income. That's two-thirds. That means that for the average family, the average house is two-thirds more expensive than they can afford. We have Vancouver is the second most expensive housing market in the world behind Hong Kong, and Toronto is number six when you compare average income to average house price. And housing prices rose record levels last year in a time when immigration was down and GDP fell by $120 billion. None of this making any sense whatsoever. That said, there are causes driven by the federal government that explain some of the story. And the one, of course, is that the Bank of Canada is printing money, pumping it into the financial system, and it's being lent out and driving up demand. But CMHC has a role here as well. You, as a mortgage insurer, are taking the risk off the lender and putting them on the taxpayer, which creates a distortion that separates risk from return. And anybody who can earn a return without a risk is going to engage heavily in the activity that produces that return. How much, what is the total dollar value of all the mortgage debt in Canada that CMHC insures, not just through portfolio and transaction insurance, but for through other securitization and Canada mortgage bond products, the total dollar value?
That, if you'd give me a moment, I will try and, I don't have that at my fingertips, but I will get it for you shortly if I may.
Sure.
Perhaps
yes.
In response to another question.
Yes, that would be just fine. What is clear, though, is that banks are overwhelmingly, instead of using covered bonds, which are basically backed up by solid and excessive collateral, they're using government-backed insurance, either by having their customers pay for it up front or by bundling up all their mortgages and getting an insurance stamp from you or Genworth and Canada Guarantee. But they are not, they are choosing to use government-backed insurance instead of using collateral. Do you not believe that this is creating a major distortion in our housing system, which allows the banks to have the profit and the taxpayers to have the risk, and housing prices to skyrocket as a result?
I don't quite agree. And thank you for your comments up front about my service. The politics aside reference I smirked at, because of course I've served you, sir, as minister, and,
yes,
and the current Liberal government as well, proudly, I should say. The mortgage insurance is required by the Bank Act, and so it's mandated by Parliament, not by CMHC. I will say that CMHC makes a significant amount of profit, or in the neighborhood of $1 billion or so a year off this business, which then is returned to the federal treasury.
Well, there's no doubt about that. The government's making lots of short-term profit, but if housing prices do drop, as you have predicted they will, and mortgage and people default on their mortgages, there will be mortgage defaults. And then all of a sudden, taxpayers will be losing money paying out that default insurance to the banks and other lenders. How much do you think we could end up paying out to those who are insured by these products?
We run stress tests every year outlining a range of scenarios. We, of course, retain capital for the purposes of that, as do the other mortgage insurers. And the private mortgage insurers, in addition, have equity capital, private equity capital ahead of them. All of that is absorbed before the government would have to pay on its guarantee. And we are satisfied in our significant stress testing, which involves scenarios that are wildly more pessimistic than anything I forecasted, that we have sufficient capital on hand. OSFI regulates and oversees the other mortgage insurers, and I'm sure has satisfied themselves of the same of those two businesses.
How much have you set aside?
Our capital, it's in the many billions of dollars. Right now, I think we have around $16 billion of capital. There's also something called insurance for business losses not yet recorded. There's a couple of categories. but it's many billions of dollars.
Right. Well, I suggest you set aside.
Last question, Pierre.
I suggest you set aside many more billions of dollars because when interest rates rise back to normal levels, trouble this way comes. And I hope that we have the many, many, many billions of dollars set aside to pay for the resulting damage. In conclusion, do you think it is fair that we have a system where the bankers get the profits, the home buyer gets the costs, and the taxpayers get all the risk?
Well, I don't think the taxpayers do get all the risk, as I said to you. By the way, in response to your prior question, mortgage insurance, we have $438 billion of those on our books, and mortgage funding or securitization is about half a trillion, $500 billion. That, by the way, has the credit support before it of mortgage insurance, and so our risk there is actually only the timely payment guarantee between a default and our recovery on the insurance. So it's not quite additive.
So just to get to Mr. Chair, if I could just conclude on that clarification. So you said you have a half a trillion dollars.
$500 billion, yep.
And that is that account.
Of securitization timely payment guarantee through CMHC.
Right.
And that would have behind it, I'm sorry to overtalk you,
yep.
Would have behind it insurance for the credit
right.
exposure.
So there's some double counting, understandably.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, we're talking over a half trillion dollars that taxpayers are on the hook for. Could be on the hook for in the event of mass mortgage default loss.
Could be, although I do want to reassure committee members that we are very confident through our stress testing that we have sufficient capital on hand to absorb any most foreseeable losses, any foreseeable losses.
Pray that you're right.
Thank you very much.